I just kept trying to get a little. good evening, Tokyo. This is the loudest crowd so far here. This is a little bit of Paul McCartney for you. This is something called Live and Let Die. When you were young and your heart wasn't open, but you could say live and let live. But if this ever changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry, say live and let die. Give me some of that bass thing, tough man.
I'll see your sister in her Sunday dress. She's got the blues, I'll take that. I've been taking no need to try. You let it to me. It's so easy. Everybody's on the easy. It's so easy. Everybody's on the easy. I walk back to you every night. I think they can find everything inside. Make a fire, I use the firelight. Make a bullseye every night. It's so easy, everybody's trying to be.
Song that we wrote about 1 year before Mr. Brownstone. With the help of our friend Wes Darkeen and some guy that just, I don't know, his name just escapes me. This is called Bad Obsession, featuring Mr. Teddy Zigzag on the harmonica. Slash on a Travis Bean. Thank you. it's always messing with my mind. It's a bad obsession. It's always messing. It's always messing with my mind. Too bad. Yo, fuck. To be wasted, always try to take it down into my vein. I call the doctor, he's just another. He said I'm sick in the brain. He said you ain't special, so who you fooling? Don't try and get me in line. But I can't stop thinking of doing it one more time. Won't know, but I already left you in the bed. It's a bad obsession. It's always messing. It's always messing with my mind. It's a bad obsession. It's always messing. It's always messing with my mind. So bad. Little number sung by Mr. Duff McKagan. Something that we hope to put out on a punk cover album. It's an old song by the Misfits, and this is called Attitude. And we'll dedicate this to Mr. Craig Duswalk.
To use the words of my friend Axel, wake up! It's time to die! I can't believe what you said.
I know what the drummer's thinking in his head, you know, because I was a drummer for 7 years. And I still do play drums. And actually, I've just been finishing up with a solo record where I play everything on it. Yeah, it's going to be coming out here in Japan in summer, or yeah, late summer. Yeah, so I'm on Geffen. Yeah, it's cool, it's fun, it was fun. I mean, it's something that I could do, I was afforded the opportunity to do, which I'm grateful, you know. So I know what's going on in Matt's mind, drum-wise, you know. I'm nowhere near as good a drummer as he is, or nothing like that, but at least I know what he's thinking. I know what Slash is thinking, and it really helps me out, and it helps, you know, everybody out. So it's like I'm kind of put into a kind of conductor type of position, you know?
This is the still the Get in the Ring tour. So,
do you know where the fuck you are, Tokyo? You in the jungle? Wake up! Time to die! We'll be right back.
This is the first song we ever wrote for In Guns N' Roses. You might know the video. This is called Don't Cry.
Don't you cry tonight, I still love you, baby. Don't you cry. Well, he's done a really good job considering that he only had about 2 weeks to learn the entire set, you know, of tunes. And basically, we don't learn a set. We learn, like, a lot of songs. So he learned about 30 tunes for the tour, and we picked from those. So, you know, in that respect, he learned a lot of stuff in a short period of time, which was really great.
Gilby was the guy that fit in, like, right off, same way that Matt worked out, you know. And Gilby was the only guy that we actually had come down to the studio and rehearse on stage with us, you know. So it was that kind of chemistry.
We'll dedicate this song to people who tell you you can never fucking get anywhere with your life. This is a song called Double Talking Jive, Motherfucker.
Oh! collective annihilation, American government, a visible force that will create a vacuum. Then we fill that vacuum as popular war advances and uses grow.
The new man on the guitar, here to play some Rolling Stones for you, Mr. Gilby Clark, the man with a new Corvette. Yeah. Set my mind at ease.